So somebody asked me, gosh, you haven't played Captain Fingers in 25 years, Lee. That's a hard tune. How was it? And I said, well, it's still hard, you know. And they said, well, could you play it as good now as you did then? I said, that's not a fair question, because back then we played it every Tuesday night for 5 years, you know. So give me that club again every Tuesday night for the next 5 years, and then record it, and it'll be fine, you know. But actually, surprisingly enough, it was great anyway, because it all just kind of came back.
Tonight we have another tune that we want to play from vintage baked potato days, the 70s, and this is a tune I wrote with great singer songwriter Bill Chaplin from Chicago, and it's called Morning Glory. And we have a beautiful young lady to introduce to you, and she comes from a great dynasty of singer songwriters. I want to introduce Miss Kenya Hathaway.
Thank you. Kenya Hathaway.
It's so nice to hear this, to see this, to feel this, because it is it's for me, it's a spiritual thing. It's a spiritual music. It's like it's 5, 6, or 7 people in one room negotiating, having a communication, communicating with one another through their instruments, coming up with ideas, not knowing where one is going to go from one moment to the next, but the journey is the cool thing about it.
We'll start the song kind of straight up, and like you say, we start to go off and off, and then it comes back in different ways. And what's great about this project, you can see it on the video, you can see that interplay, and you can see that communication going on.
That moment when everyone is connected, there's complete trust. So the person who is the soloist can just express themselves, knowing that everyone else that's accompanying them is reacting based upon, you know, a particular idea and expression. And it sounds to the listener a lot of times when everybody's really on the same page that they all go off in these completely different directions. But at its best, everyone knows where they are at all times. At all times. Then when the moment is right for us to kind of reel it back in a little bit and relate it to where we took off, where the journey took off, to relate it again to the idea, the original idea, it's magical.
Thank you.
Thank you. So I just realized, you know, this is going to be really strange because I'm going to play with my thin backside to all of you all night. But that way you're in the shot, you know. So it's cool. And by the way, we've got to introduce all these great musicians. Mr. Dave Grusin on piano. Baby Fingers, Patrice Russian. Yeah. The man, Ernie Watts. Anthony Jackson on bass. Steve Foreman on percussion. Harvey Mason on drums. Think about Harvey. Leave it now. All right, and we're going over to the baked potato later.
What I've really enjoyed doing in the last few years is also cultivating a lot of young players and seeing their talent and feeling like a talent scout, you know. And I guess I've actually, even when I was in my 20s and then 30s and 40s and now I'm 50, there was always that part of me that always knew how to find other great musicians. And sometimes they weren't well known at that time and they joined my band and later went on to do, you know, really big things. Thank you.
Melvin Davis on the bass, Eric Marienthal, Oscar Seaton, Barnaby Finch. Thank you.
it's exciting to have this quality of a project with these great musicians. People say, oh yeah, that's right. Wow, they're playing together. They're interacting. They're like, wow, they can really play their instruments. It's great music, you know. So I think that's important for a young audience to see this too, because I think the young audience is kind of forgetting that, or maybe they don't even know that it still exists, you know.
As far as young people are concerned, I think that's possibly an untapped market for this kind of music. I know some kids who didn't grow up with this, but when they hear it, their ears pick up, you know, so I think that's a definite possibility.
I really do think people younger people would enjoy it more if they were exposed to it. They're not really exposed to it. There's no outlet for them to even hear it. So something like this being in the market, I think, is just a wonderful, wonderful thing.
I think it really will enhance jazz for people to see the excitement that's created and the spontaneity that happens on the spot. So I think it'll be great for new audiences to see that haven't taken the chance or taken the time to go into a club. So I think it'll be great.
It's amazing. It's such a great music, you know. It's great players, you know. I think that's the people that loves music, you know, is going to enjoy this project totally, you know. It's just for people that loves music.
There's a lot more than what's going on now. I mean, we have the pop culture, everybody's into what they're, but man, there's nothing like carrying on a conversation with your bandmate.
I think the sophistication of our music is going to have a nice niche there, because there's a lot of people out there that don't want to hear this stuff.
Thank you.
Lock the doors. Here we go.
Lee asked me to give him a couple of examples of where my vocal texture was so he could see which songs he wanted me to sing background on or if he wanted me to do some lead. And I gave him that CD, and a couple of days later he called me up and asked me if he could do it. And I couldn't believe it.
And I kept hearing about this young lady, Kenya Hathaway, and I knew she was the daughter of the very, very, very famous Donny Hathaway and the sister of Layla Hathaway. So I called her up and I said, I've got this project happening in 2 weeks and I need somebody now. And I said, I've heard that you're quite, quite talented. And I said, can you send me your demo reel? So she sent me the reel and she came over and she introduced herself and we jammed a little bit in my studio and I listened to her CD and I said, you're on, you're hired.
Kenya's voice to me, obviously is an extension of her father, Donny Hathaway. And she sounds like her dad. And her voice to me is very spiritual.
There was just such a warm feeling to be performing with people that I've been listening to all of my life, all of my life that have played with my father and that I grew up listening to around the house. So I got into it. I got into it. I really enjoyed it. And I will never live this down. I'll never live this experience down. It was just amazing.
All right, we're going to turn to a few vocal tunes here now. This is two of my new favorite singers. And this first gentleman has been singing with me for a little less than a year. And he comes from a great musical family, five brothers, all sing and dance. They got a great band that you're going to hear about called Brother. And I want you to give a warm welcome to Mr. Grady Harrell. Come on, Grady.
Yeah.
All right. The young lady coming up, she's comes from this musical dynasty of Donny Hathaway, Layla Hathaway, and give a warm welcome to a great talent, Miss Kenya Hathaway. Yeah, yeah. And like her papa, she's a writer. And I heard this tune of hers. I think you wrote it fairly recent, right? And so we're going to do her tune, feature a little bit of Kenya and the band here. It's called Possibilities. Check it out.
Take a chance, take a chance.
Thank you very much. We're going to bring up one more guest here. Great trumpet player that first became world renowned through Sting's band. And he's made quite a splash with his own records. And this year he joined us on the Twist of Motown, all the great Motown tunes that we did. And we're going to feature the great Mr. Chris Botti. Along with Kenya Hathaway, Grady Harrell, Oscar Seton, Melvin Davis, Barnaby Finch, Eric Marienthal in the Shadows, myself, Mr. Lee Ritman, and you, Hollywood.
This is Papa Was a Rolling Stone. Saving souls and all the time leeching, dealing in dirt, stealing in the name of the Lord. Spend most of his time chasing women and drinking. Mama, I'm depending on you to tell me the truth.
Oscar Seton. Oh, yeah. Thank you.
crazy too.
This was a wonderful experience to set up the stage as we did. Normally, you know, you're all on a flat across a stage and you're looking out at an audience who's a little distance away. And this way, where we played in a circle and we played in kind of this unplugged kind of environment, and you know, you don't know if it's a studio, you don't know if it's somebody's house, a living room, a club. And we're not going to tell anyone, you know, because it doesn't matter. It ended up being an incredible environment. And once I explained to the musicians on the phone, to Dave Grusin, to Patrice, to Harvey Mason, to Ernie Watts, Anthony, Oscar Seton, Melvin Davis, all the guys, I said, this is going to be a little different. You know, you can invite a few people, but we're not really concerned about the audience. We're going to play to each other in kind of a circle. And they said, really? That's fantastic. You mean just like when we're rehearsing over at your house? I said, yeah, just like that.
The way that this was done, with us kind of all sitting around each other and, you know, that's the way we usually work. Now, most people would say, well, no, I go to a concert, and you're over there, and he's over there, and he's on a riser, and he's down here, and blah, blah, blah. And yeah, that's the way we've been known to present it. That's been the way it's been presented for years and years and years. But with the technology that we have now, the things that we have now, I think one of the things that's important is for people to be able now to use the technology to allow us to feel more.
Because in some cases, we're live things sometimes mean concerts, arenas, with stacks of amplifiers and a lot of noise and a lot of volume and so forth, in an attempt to incite a crowd to madness, you know. Or there's the club situation, which is all kind of intimate and close and acoustic, and this is somewhere in between. This is a totally different experience.
It is about the experience of the music, not just hearing the music. It's experiencing the music with the knowledge that you are witnessing something for the first and the last time. It will never be as it is at that moment. And what a joy it is, you know, for everybody to have an opportunity, at least for an hour or two, to operate completely in the moment. It's great.
This type of get-together, with or without the production going on, is just rare. Thank you.
Thank you.
a soloist like Lee, who's you know, among the elite, he has to be able to find people who can play, who can support his desire to play.
We've still got that childlike fun. You know, it was just so much fun, you know, just jamming with Dave and Patrice and Ernie and Harvey and Anthony and the new guys and Kenya and the young ones and the old ones. It was just fun, you know, and that's what music's supposed to be.
There's nothing more fun than playing with other musicians that you respect and enjoy, and the reunion aspect of it is fun too, you know, all of these guys going way back.
Being with all these guys, you know, it's been such a pleasure.
Is something so fresh and something so alive about it that I think that it will transcend like a barrier, like a musical barrier. It was fun. It was fun and it felt good. And that's all people really need.
I think you can see, you can feel that we belong playing together. There's no doubt about that.
Very, very, very. Very loose, the people were having a great time, so it was very comfortable. I had a ball, it was fun to do.
So I think that this, it will be inspirational for a lot of people. And you know what? It'll be fun. And if that's all that it does, if it brings people a few hours of enjoyment, it was worth every second.
I think for me, if this project can do something, I'd like to have it show that music can reach all different kind of boundaries and that it can all happen on the same stage in the same day, all at the same time. She looks easy, she gets so full. Flower in the garden, bobbing the sunlight, flirting with her eyes. When she walks by, see a wave of color. Moving like an angel, trailing butterflies. Give me water, give me inspiration. I wanna speak now, but I can't find a word. So I'm forgiving my infatuation. Now that I know she walks upon the earth, she walks the earth. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thanks for coming out.
Thank you.
Dave Grusin, Yvonne Lenz, Anthony Jackson, Steve Foreman, Alex Acuna, Harvey Mason. Thank you. Good night.